It's the divisional round for the Ravens coming up this Saturday afternoon at home at M&T Bank Stadium. They're hosting the Houston Texans at 4:30 p.m. You can hear it on WBAL and 98 Rock. And we're going to break down what you should be looking forward to for this game. Now, the Ravens had their bye week, so they're well-rested going into this. But it's going to be freezing temperatures. We're looking at about 25 degrees, maybe some flurries at kickoff. But my number one question going into this is, we saw Mark Andrews returning to practice just under 2 months after he went under surgery for that ankle, fractured fibula. What do you see out of Mark Andrews that, what's the percent of him coming back?
Yeah, I think it's always good to add players like his caliber. Pro Bowler, I think it's fantastic to have him out there practicing. I think if he can play, let him go out there and play and really be a productive two tight end set now with Likely and Andrews on the field at the same time. That's got to be incredible, and that only makes this offense much more, it just makes it much more complete. It just makes it more dimensional in terms of not being one-dimensional, and you can do different things. So I love it that he's able to at least get out there and play.
We're excited to be joined by Femi Ayanbadejo today, former Ravens player. So when you look at this team, now they faced the Houston Texans in week one, but both of these teams have changed so much since then.
Absolutely.
18 weeks of a full season.
Yeah.
What do we have to see from the Ravens that could be different from what we've been seeing?
Well, I think they're just a lot more comfortable in their skin now. They know who they are. They were kind of laying track as the train was moving, which is difficult to do. But, you know, this is the NFL. We expect high wire acts like that. Coach Monken came in, put his thumb on the scale. I love the evolution of the offense, and I think you hit the nail on the head. Having Likely and Andrews together in two tight end packages, let Likely carry the load. Work Mark in smartly. Intelligently, and use him in opportunities that will allow Lamar to run pass option, right? Allow Mark to run routes that he's comfortable with based on that ankle. And we've already seen the rise of Isaiah Likely, and that opportunity only came due to Mark's injury. That's the silver lining. But I think the ability to exploit that matchup, I don't know how much they can do in such a short window. But I think what gets me excited, and not to look too far down the road, is the future of Andrews and Likely as a real kind of complementary two tight end set. We'll see what they can squeeze out of that, but I'm really excited about it. Now, let me say one more thing. I think that the defense is also different. They've evolved, right? And let's give them their flowers. The first team in NFL history to lead the NFL in takeaways, right? Points per game and sacks. Never been done. The 2000 team didn't even do that. So when I think about the evolution of the Texans and the evolution of the Ravens, I think they've both evolved. But if they both evolved equally, we saw the outcome of the first game. I'm not saying that it always works that way. I'm not saying that, because I think Houston is represents their head coach,
right.
Demeco Ryans, who I am a big fan of.
Yeah. Yes.
And so I love the evolution of the team. I think we're going to have a great game on Saturday afternoon.
We'll get to the defense in just a second, but you mentioned Lamar Jackson there. This is going to be his first playoff game really in 3 years almost. Obviously missed him with injury the last couple of years. So what has he learned since 2019 when they were in a very similar situation with the Tennessee Titans coming to town?
Well, he certainly has grown since 2019, his second year. And I think all of this talk about the 1-3 in the playoffs and the 2019, I think sometimes we get caught up, and I heard you speak about that earlier, and I feel the same way. We get caught up in the past. But this is a different team. It's different in a lot of ways. I mean, Lamar, he's a little bit wiser and older, and he even said that. You know, this team is different. The defensive makeup is different than that 2019 team. So I think, yes, it's, you can have it in the back of your mind, but you have to look at this as an entirely different team and mindset. And I think that they've done a great job of focusing one game at a time. And they have leaders on this team on both sides of the ball now.
Yes.
That are really sort of getting the guys focused in on the task at hand. So I love it.
And maybe another thing that we can focus in on is the coaching of this team. The matchup, when you look at the Ravens versus the Texans, you've got John Harbaugh, who's been at the head of this team for 16 seasons now. And then you've got Demeco Ryans, who is a very defensive forward coach, but he's in his first year as a head coach for the Texans. But this is really his team. So he's galvanized the Houston Texans. They're young with their rookie, CJ Stroud. But when you look at the coaching matchup of this, what do you see from these two?
Yeah, and I'll say one thing about 2019 before I answer that question.
Go for
is
it.
That, and I said this on air, our PTSD as fans is not their PTSD. Our trauma is not their trauma.
Makes sense, yeah.
Those guys, a lot of those guys weren't there for that,
right.
And they don't care about that. So I know as fans and as people that are deeply emotionally attached to the outcome of this game and this team. I totally understand. Let it go, though. Let it go. It's in the past.
Let it go.
In regard to Demeco Ryans and Coach Harbaugh, we have a future Hall of Famer as our head coach. But the thing is that this game, this is one game. It's going to be played on Saturday on the field. And you can't underestimate the experience that Demeco Ryans has had as a San Francisco 49er coach,
yes,
defensive coordinator, and as a player.
Right.
Highly intelligent, productive player, highly intelligent defensive coordinator. To look at, I remember looking at a post that I had created on Facebook at the end of last football season, and my top five franchises in trouble. Houston was in that list.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
They were in that list.
Yeah.
And look at them now.
Yes.
They have skyrocketed. And
yeah,
guess what? Houston is going to be a problem. They are going to be a problem going forward. But in regard to C.J. Stroud and Demeco Ryans, and you know, I think they're the third or fourth tandem rookie head coaches. Coach Harbaugh and Joe Flacco also have that you know, rookie head coach, rookie quarterback going and winning a playoff game,
yeah,
right? So I think that it's going to be interesting, but I don't think it's going to matter so much. When it comes down to one game, I think head coach experience, I think, navigates a team throughout the season. But the game plan, the supporting cast, the other coaches, I think it's going to be boiled down to this game. And I think momentum is real. And I think that, you know, the last five, six, seven games, the trend also matters. And both teams are on a really, really good trend. So, like I said, I'm looking forward to a very an early feeling out process in the first quarter.
Yeah.
But my instinct tells me that the Ravens will get a lead and that C.J. Stroud is going to have to find a way to come back. And will he put the ball in harm's way? Will he create opportunities for Kyle Hamilton? Will he create opportunities for Geno Stone?
Yeah.
Will he create opportunities for PQ and other guys that are at the linebacker and secondary level to make plays? I think they will. Will they be able to make those plays? If they make those plays, they lock the game up. If they don't make those plays, Houston, once again, we have a problem.
And there's a lot on the line here as we get ready for the divisional matchup. It's the Baltimore Ravens hosting the Houston Texans this Saturday, January 20th, 4:30 p.m. at M&T Bank Stadium. You can hear the pregame on WBAL and 98 Rock. I'll be out there on Ravens Walk with Kirk McHugh and Joe Robinson. I already ordered new UGG boots because it's going to be 25 degrees. We're getting sub-zero temperatures here, maybe some flurries. Mark is going on. How are you going to prep, Tony?
It's going to be the same thing. I'm doing the pregame show for WBAL at 1 o'clock in the concourse, yes, in the stadium. So we're going to start off with myself, Keith Mills, and Brian Neiman, who is going to be cynical as usual. So I'm looking forward to his take on this game. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be cold.
But no, it's doubt. January. It's football weather, and we are all excited for it. So come out and say hi. The Ravens and Texans this Saturday.